Hey guys, welcome back in CodeSphere. So today in this video I will show you how you can implement navigation drawer in your Android app. So as you can see that when I will click on this hamburger icon, so there are items, home, gallery, slideshow, title, tools, and this is our menu icon. So when I will click on this, then there is a setting. So and you can also see that there is a gradient in the background. So how you can do this in your Android app, I will show you. So without wasting time, let's start. So guys, in this video we will start from scratch. So we will simply choose a start a new Android project, and you can see that there are types of activities. You can choose whatever you want. So we will choose navigation drawer activity and simply click on next, and then we will give it a name, navigation then finish. So guys, in this video we are choosing this activity because Android Studio makes it available for us. So I don't think that we should waste time, because there are a lot of videos on YouTube. They are showing, they are trying to show that design navigation drawer from scratch. But I think it is absolutely useless, because when Android Studio makes it available, it gives you dummy coding. You don't need to scratch it from design. You don't need to waste hours on doing it. So that's why. But people still show you that how you can design it from scratch. It is very difficult and it's a heavy stuff. So that's why I used a pre-designed activity. So it is a very good time saver, and you can see that in the updated version of Android Studio, because in the older versions what we get that there is a main activity and navigation drawer and menu, but in the updated version you can see that there is another directory of name UI, and inside that UI there are different classes and another sub directory. So this is for gallery, and this is for home, this is for send. So I will run this blank app without doing any coding for showing you that how it really works and what is new in this updated version. So we don't need to design it from scratch, because it is a waste of time, and that's why I have chosen this activity, and it is very useful. So what is happening in this one is that Android Studio already gives you fragments. So you can see that there is already fragments. You can see fragment underscore XML, fragment underscore gallery, home, send, share. So that is a very good thing that I have seen in Android Studio in updated version. So you can see that this is a blank app. We have done nothing. It is simply when I will click on home. So you can see that this is a home fragment, and this is a different fragment. It is not like that tabbed activity in our last tutorial of Android Studio. So you can see that this is a different fragment, and when you will click on this menu icon, so this is a sub item. So and this is a floating action button. We can replace it by our own action. So first of all, let's make some changes inside it. So what we have to do is first of all go to gallery fragment, and here what we will do is simply edit. We can use another one, so text view, wrap content, and then wrap content, and the text will be gallery, and done. And then we can give it text size 30 sp, and then let's fix its constants. Then click on this red one and then add. So now you can see that error is gone. And now we have to fix its orientation. So simply let me fix it. Actually, that's why I use linear layout every time all my tutorials, because it is very good. All you need to do is simply give one child that gravity center and thing, everything is fine. So now you can see that there is a gallery, and this is a text that we have given inside it. So next one is fragment underscore home. So here, first of all, I will change this layout, because I don't like constant layout. Literally I like linear layout, because in linear layout you can give gravity and a center. So after this, whenever I will use text view, wrap content, and then text will be home, and text size 30 sp, then done. So set orientation, okay. So let's give it orientation vertical. Now it's fine. So guys, you can see that now our fragment home.xml file is complete. So I'm just showing a demo that you can change inside this XML file, but I'm not going in detail. I am just showing you a demo. So now I will show you how you can change the background of our nav header. So you can see that now there is a icon and text Android Studio, and this is androidstudio.com. So how can we change it is simply go to drawable and then click right and then go to new, and here we will create a drawable resource file and we will give it name background, then okay selector. So now instead of selector we will write shape, and after this we will write gradient, then angle 90, then start color, then end color, and then yeah. So now what we have to do is simply go to values and then inside here in colors, and here we will define two colors, the starting color and ending color. So simply copy this and paste it, and its name will be start color and its name will be end color, and then we will give it, so the code of start color is hashtag 3994DD, and end colors code is hashtag 8AE0EB. So now let me close this. Now it's fine. Yeah. So now again go back to background.xml and then here start color. So in start color we have to write color, color, actually here we have to give end color, and here we have to give start color. So now you can see that this is our background XML file and it is complete. So again this, simply close it and again come back to here, and then inside here background we will give drawable background. So now you can see that this is changed, and here this is our image view, and we have to delete this one, and now again we have to go to drawable, and here we will choose a new vector asset for icon. So simply click on this, and now it is, so here simply write contact. Contact, it is not showing in, yes this one is good, then click OK, and we will give it name ICAC, then OK, then finish, done ICAC, and then go here, and now we will change its color, we will make it white. So now it is white, then close it, then again go back here, and here simply we have to do is drawable ICAC. I can see that, and change its width to 50 dp. We can give more 100 dp, and height also 100 dp, depends on you that how much big you want to make it. And then here text view you can change it to, oops, text view, you can write account, then text color Android white, and then text size 20 SP. Yeah, that's fine. And we don't need this third one, so let me delete this. This is not something. Source compat, simply click. Now it is fine, the error is gone. So we can make it small. I think it's looking too big, so 80 I think is fine. And yeah, now it is looking good. So now what will happen, that now we have to do nothing more than this. Is now it's time to run the Android app and see how it looks. Now hopefully it will look more better. So as now our app is running, and whenever you click on this icons, you can see that this is looking quite good. And if we want to change this, you know, if we will go on this home, we will go on galleries, you can see that this is a text that we have given. So we can also make some more changes, that if you want to change its color. So we can give this code control plus C here, and then paste it here. So now hopefully it will work very good. So again, run the Android app and see the changes, that how is it looking, because now it is looking too ugly, as you can see that. Yeah, now it's looking good. So now you can see that this is the gradient in our background, and this is, there are different fragments. So in this updated version, you don't need to design it from scratch. Android Studio makes it available. And this is our sub items menu. I will show you where it is. So for making changes, you have to go to menu and then main.xml. And there is our one icon setting. So guys, this was a quick tutorial about navigation drawer in Android app, how you can implement it. So if you like this video, then please like, share and subscribe my channel. And don't forget to press the bell icon, then, because I will upload more interesting videos like this, then you will never miss any update. And thank you for watching.